Greetings, this is Brad from the Cheese Shop. The Cheese Shop is my tabletop RPG blog that I run. I've been running it for about a year and a half now. And I decided that I would like to do a video, and I tried to think of different things to talk about. And I figured one thing I could talk about would be a game system that I run. One of the game systems that I run is called GURPS. And the book I want to talk about is the GURPS 4th Edition Basic Set. It's the characters version of that. So there's two books that are part of the basic set. The first one is Characters, which essentially goes over character creation and its development. And then the second book is more for the GM, and it is geared towards combat, creating adventures, and dealing with situations. To give you a little background on the book, at the very beginning, it talks about what is role-playing. It also talks about, you know, where Steve Jackson, who's the creator of GURPS, actually got some of the ideas about the system and how where the system has progressed to the 4th edition. It also gives you a little bit of a quick start guide to get players just immediately immersed into the system, without having to get fully, you know, immersed with all of the rules. You can actually go through and just get a few of the rules down, and then you can just start playing, you know, if you have your GM. So it's really, I wanted to make this for the newer player that was thinking about doing and playing GURPS and possibly creating a character. So there's the contents of the system are essentially the character creation, and then it goes through some other chapters dealing with what you would do when you're creating your character, and then also part of the character development. Also, GURPS is a system that is point-based, which means that when you make a character, everything that you get that's some sort of advantage or something above the norm costs points. Anything that is actually hinders you or is something that is less than the norm is, you know, you lose points. And what that means is that if you created a character, and GURPS actually goes through and says that a 100-point character would be considered a hero type character. You know, that would be someone that's, you know, maybe a seasoned adventurer and is, you know, ready to take on the world by themselves or, you know, with others, and can pretty much hold their own. Normal people, like most of us, you know, we may have some, you know, gifts, but we also have some weaknesses as well. And our characters would, if we were to make a point system of ourselves, would typically not be in the 100-point range. It'd be more in the, you know, in between 50 and probably 75, you know, where they're just the regular people that are on the street. We're not exceptional, you know, beyond just a few little things. So, like I said, the 100-point character would be someone that, you know, the stories are written about and, you know, novels are based on. And then because it is a point-based system, you can actually, you know, have as many points to spend on a character as you'd like. A superhero would be, to give you an example, would be something like 500 points or 300 points, you know, and you would have superpowers, or, you know, you're not able to die, or you know, you have stone skin or something like that. Those things obviously are advantages, and those advantages cost a good deal of points, and someone that's a superhero would actually have a lot more of those. So you could play essentially any type of character in a point-based system. You're not just, you know, class is not something that you're constricted by. So if you wanted to make someone that could, you know, fight really well and, you know, was really smart, or you can do anything that you wanted using the point-based system, and the constraints are only whatever the GM says for that adventure. So if the GM tells you it's a 100-point campaign and you start with an adventure with a character with 100 points, that's all you get. And then as you progress and you start to develop your character, then actually more points can be allotted and your character gets better in some respects. So knowing that it's a point-based system, this book actually does cover advantages, disadvantages, skills, which all cost points. So your character itself has attributes that you go through, and those cost points as well. So whenever you're making your character, you're thinking of your character concept, you essentially go through and the book in the advantages, disadvantages, skill sections, and you decide what would that character have. So for instance, if I was making a farmer that was a pacifist that just lost his family and the bank is coming to foreclose on his farm, and he's set in, you know, 1946. I could make that character, and what I would do is I'd go through and I'd say, okay, well, like, what kind of disadvantages would he have? You know, what kind of skills would he have? You know, skills, obviously, he'd have farmer skills. He would have different types of skills. And you could really, in this system, create a great many types of characters. I mean, the possibilities are endless at this point. It's really just based on, you know, what kind of concept you have for your character. Now, when you go through this book, and like I said, you're going through the character creation, it talks a little bit about what the concept of the character should be, and how you try to figure that out. You ask yourselves different types of questions about what your character is. And if you answer those questions, then you can go through the advantages, disadvantages, and the skills, and you can pick out relevant, you know, items from those three. And with that, you can decide how well your character does something. So in the case of the farmer, let's say that, you know, he was really good at, he hunted as well. So he's really good at shooting a rifle. So he may have a higher rifle skill than the normal person would that, you know, just does it, you know, is only shot once or twice. So the better skill you have, the more points it actually costs to be better at that specific skill. So you'll start seeing it as you go through the book that, you know, different things cost different point amounts. And then your goal is to get 200 points. So anything, like I said, that is positive to your character is a positive number for the points. Anything that's a negative to your character is a negative thing to the points. So once you've got your character set up through, you know, the advantages, disadvantages, and skills, the rest of the book touches lightly on magic and psionics. So I can see that in not every genre would you need necessarily magic or psionics to, you know, with the example of the farmer that in 1946 that lost his farm, more than likely there's not going to be any kind of magic or psionics in this particular adventure. But there could be. So that's one of the reasons why this system is so diverse. It can cover so many different things. They also have a section that actually talks about templates, and this is a lot for, I think this is a section that's mostly for people that are kind of unsure. They come from a class system background, like either they play Dungeons and Dragons or something like that, where there's a fighter and a cleric, and you know there's a barbarian and things like that. The templates help those type of characters that are just kind of borderline, don't really know what kind of character they want to make. They kind of know, and maybe they can just use the template just to get started and start playing. Because, you know, when you start playing role-playing games, I've found regardless of which one it is, you tend to play, you just keep playing. So the templates are there to give players a guide to actually creating something that's more a class and just kind of get them started. Another thing that's in the book is the equipment section, and that's just what it sounds like. The equipment is everything from, you know, swords and slings to plasma weapons. There are not a lot of those things in the actual book, so, you know, it doesn't have every single type of gun that's out there. There's other books that Steve Jackson Games puts together for GURPS that go through and go into greater detail with that And I'll talk about that in another video, kind of just like background of other stuff. But the book finishes off, because essentially if you've gotten down to the equipment and you've bought everything for your character, so at that point you know what your character is. In the case of the farmer, you know he's a farmer, you know what he's good at, you know what kind of disadvantages he may have, what skills he has, and you've got him equipped and he's ready to go out on the adventure. The character development section talks about how you actually go about, you know, finishing off the character throughout the character's life. So it gives you ideas of, you know, what it takes to actually do, what it takes to develop the character. So that's, the whole book itself is completely about characters, obviously, because it's, you know, that's what it's called, the characters. It doesn't go into detail about combat or anything like that. So, because typically with the characters, you're going to be the one playing, and the GM is the one that's going to be running the combat. So that's why the next book is actually about campaigns and setting up and running adventures. But one thing that I liked about the book is that its layout is great. It's every page is essentially three columns, so it's very easy to read. The table of contents is, which I've touched on, you know, with the character creation, advantages, disadvantages, etc. Everything is easy to find. I mean, you know that if something, you're looking for something that's going to be beneficial to your character, you know you don't need to be going around the, you know, the magic section, or you don't need to be going into the disadvantages section. You know where it's going to be in advantages. Anything that's not beneficial, obviously, you're going to be looking in some other place. So it's really easy for the first time RPGer to actually go in and take a look and see what they need to find. It's really easy to find. And there's obviously also an index as well. So one of the things that you can do if you're trying, when you're making your character, is just peruse through all of the information that you see there, and just kind of, if you're having a hard time deciding like what kind of character you want, you can just read a little bit about, you know, some advantages or disadvantages, and then start there and see, maybe that will, you know, spark some sort of interest in you. So again, with the layout, like I said, it's got three columns for each page, and on each of those pages there's a slew of information. There's also sections where there's footnotes or sidebars. There's sidebars, and they can be anywhere on the page, that actually give you a little bit more information or more specific information about, you know, a greater topic. So like in the example of the languages section, you know, it goes through in the three columns and it's talking about languages, and then there's a little blurb about more specifics with the language, whether it's examples or things like that. So the book itself is actually a really good book. It's a hardcover book, so, and it has the RPG book smell to it. It's got the, you know, that glossy paper. So it's a really good book. I used it a bunch. I mean, the ends are really, I've started to wear the ends down a little bit, but for the most part, I mean, I use this all the time. So it's actually made really well. You know, hasn't split from the binding or anything like that. So now I just wanted to finish and say that I plan to do some more of these reviews, and hopefully I can get to some of the different books. I'll probably stick with GURPS mostly at first, just because I've noticed that you know, there are blogs out there and even videos, there's not many about GURPS. So, and I may even go into more detail about this. I try to get this, because this is my first one. I'm trying to get this as kind of concise as I can do. And you can see when you start talking about role-playing games that you can really get off topic and just start going a lot of different directions, which essentially is what I'm doing now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to close, and I hope to see everyone online. I'll put a link to my blog and different ways to contact me. I'm pretty much everywhere on the internet. So I hope you'll have a good day, and cheers.